Yo, what's up? I'm Adam.
And I'm Justina.
And I brought Justina in to help us understand what do we do with the data once we get it into the Lakehouse. And so you'll recall we did a video with Ted where he helped us get started with creating that Lakehouse. And now Justina is going to help us understand what do we do with that data from there. We've got the data now. Yeah. We got to use it.
We do.
And so before we get into that real quick, Justina, for folks that haven't met you before, can you introduce yourself a little bit? Tell us a little bit about what you do.
Yeah, of course. So I'm Justina, and I'm the group product manager for the data engineering and data science workloads in Microsoft Fabric. So what we really try to do is empower all data engineers to be able to prepare and transform all their organizational data, share it out with the business, build out their lakehouse architecture, use Spark, and for data scientists, really to explore their data and build predictive models.
Amazing. So just a little bit of stuff.
Yeah, just, that's it. Yeah, just
all right. All right, Justina, we've got data. What do we do with it?
Well, what I suggest is we, you know, cut all this talking. Let's head over to my machine because I've got a lot to show you.
Let's do it.
Okay, so over here, we can see the lakehouse. I've already brought in all of the data. And we're actually looking at some Microsoft sales data here. Don't worry, it's all obfuscated. You know, what I wanted to show you is how you can kind of work with pretty massive amounts of data inside this Lakehouse experience. Right. So the first set of users who can benefit from the data in the Lakehouse is really the data engineers, data scientists who use notebooks and Spark. So what I can do from here is just go ahead and create myself a brand new notebook. And this is going to navigate me straight to the notebook experience. And the great thing is you can actually see the Lakehouse is automatically pinned to the side, ready for me to work with. And let's say I want to work with some of the data over here. Well, it's as simple as being able to just drag and drop this table.
Is this the new clicky, clicky, draggy, droppy?
Yes, yes, exactly. We're bringing clicky, clicky, draggy, droppy into the notebook experience.
Oh, yeah, amazing. Yeah. All right.
And let's go ahead and actually run the cell. And the great thing with notebooks in Fabric is they actually have really quick startup times. In the past, this would take like, you know, 3 to 5 minutes to get started. Yeah. But, you know, here it gets started within like 15 seconds. So within Fabric, we basically have a starter pool that comes pre-wired with every workspace. Nice. So the great news is you don't have to do anything to actually use Spark. There's no setup required. These Spark pools are just ready to go for you, and you can get started immediately.
Nice.
So we can see our pool started within like 12 seconds. And yeah, I can basically get a nice preview of my data and I can just start working with it in my notebook now. So we looked at kind of the experience of the data engineer and data scientist. But what if I'm, let's say, a SQL analyst?
Yes. Yeah.
Let's take a look at that.
Let's put our Patrick hat on.
Yeah. So I'm going to jump back into the Lakehouse and I can make use of this nice multitasking on the side over here.
I love the multitasking.
And what basically happens is with the Lakehouse, every Lakehouse comes pre-wired with a SQL endpoint. Again, I didn't have to do anything to set this up. It's just over there. So if we jump into the SQL endpoint, that is going to load up the warehouse UI. And the great thing over here is actually the warehouse front end for the Lakehouse is exactly the same experience as you would get in the full-blown warehouse artifact.
Nice.
So the consumption experience for the Lakehouse and the warehouse is exactly the same for a SQL persona. So here you can see the warehouse. I have all these familiar constructs, like my schemas. I can see my saved queries, my views. I can explore my data. But let's actually go ahead and write ourselves a new SQL query. So I'm going to go ahead and just paste in a query over here. And let's go ahead and run this. And, you know, we're doing some joins across not only different tables, but actually across a different Lakehouse and a warehouse, all within the same single query over here.
So I can actually reference those items and it just looks like a join in T-SQL.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Oh my gosh.
And it works across artifacts, which is awesome. We're working with a table that has 3.5 billion rows. We can see, you know, in just a couple of seconds, we were able to run this query and, you know, get back our result. So as a SQL user, I can use this, I can use SSMS, so my tools of choice. Yeah. And I can just
because
work
it's just
with...
it's just a TDS endpoint.
Exactly.
So any SQL tool is gonna work with that.
Exactly, exactly.
Amazing. Even Power BI.
Let's kind of move along and also look at what a BI engineer, BI analysts can do with this data.
Now you're speaking my language.
So you'll actually notice that the Lakehouse has a built-in modeling view directly into it. So we're really kind of combining the data warehouse and Power BI all in a single experience. So this might look familiar for our BI users. You can see I've got my data model over here. I've got all my different tables. I've already built my relationships and my measures. What I can basically do from here is just go in and build a new Power BI report. And you can see this is, again, I didn't have to go and wire anything together. As I'm going through this experience, I'm still doing everything from within the context of that single Lakehouse.
Now, in terms of some of the mindset from a Power BI perspective, you may think, well, what if I need to add a column? That's something where if we're leveraging the Lakehouse, we're going to want to go do that on the Lakehouse side so it elevates back up, right?
And the great thing is once you've added it in the Lakehouse, you know, again, all these experiences, the data engineer, the SQL analyst, the BI user can all benefit from that data.
And it shows up like almost instantly.
Yeah, we're automatically keeping everything in sync.
So minimizing all of that hard wiring up that you had to do and the groups you had to go talk to.
Exactly. And, so over here, we can see our tables on the side. And here, what I really want to point out is these are just pointers to the data that's sitting in the Lakehouse, in the data lake. So no data has actually been loaded into Power BI at this point. So Direct Lake is a new mode that you can work with your data. So up to now, you've had import mode and direct query. Well, Direct Lake mode brings you the best of both worlds. So you get the performance that you get with import mode, but basically Power BI is working against the data in the data lake. So you're getting that kind of real-time reporting, but with the performance of import.
Yeah, so it's like thinking about like the storage engine now is the Lakehouse.
So let's go ahead and why don't we just start with something simple. Let's do just a row count to see how much data we're actually dealing with inside here.
Wow.
Let's make this into a card. And you can see we have 3.5 billion rows of data.
I'm going to tell you, we were working on this. There's no smoke and mirrors here. No. It came up that quick.
Yeah.
That was not like... Yeah.
No preloading, no nothing. It was
just bam. It was there. Oh my gosh.
So now let's go ahead and bring in some actual revenue data. We're going to break this down by product in a second. So let's go ahead and bring in product family name and make this chart a little bit bigger. And let's go ahead and maybe break it down by fiscal quarter over here. We can change the chart. And you know, as I click around, you can kind of see everything just works really smoothly. We're getting kind of the interactivity we would expect.
Keep this in mind that this is potentially leveraging different lake houses and bringing these things together to produce these reports, which is amazing when you think about the speed that that came up.
Think of it this way. You don't have to manage ETL jobs, right? You don't have to worry about how I'm going to schedule these things, keep them in sync. It's just all working against the same
thing. And that data is not being copied somewhere else. It's just in the Lakehouse.
No.
That's it.
When we saw all the experiences we saw today, the notebooks, the SQL endpoint, the Power BI report, there was no data copying, no data movement happening whatsoever.
A lot of people use Excel. A lot of people use other tools that are out there. Can they take advantage of this as well?
Yeah. So in Excel, I can connect to my Lakehouse just like I can connect to a Power BI data set. And I can slice and dice, you know, build pivot tables, slice and dice my billions of rows of data in Excel as well. You know, behind the scenes, there's also, this is data is all sitting in an Azure storage account, right? So if I want to connect directly to the storage account, I can do that too. So this data is, you know, fully accessible and open for any tools.
So multiple options and connecting directly to the storage.
Yeah.
If you're leveraging data warehousing, then we've got the TDS endpoint that you can go after. If you've created that Power BI data set, you can just leverage the data set, and that's leveraging the Lakehouse as well. And so Excel connected to the data set, or connected directly to the lake, and or those third-party tools that you may be using is the same route. So it's all available to you.
Last thing I would add is, you know, you have the data hub. So just like you can find your data sets in the data hub, you'll be able to find your lake houses, warehouses in there as well. So really easy for business users to find it for the kind of business consumption.
And if you're not sure who to go talk to in your organization, go knock on the door of your IT group or the business group that's running Power BI or Microsoft Fabric. And go ask them. Justyna, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
If you want to see more videos on how to get started with Microsoft Fabric, check out the playlist up above and enjoy that content as you begin your journey with Microsoft Fabric. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.